A very simple way to change scenes in Godot is to use an area 2D in the map entry to detect when the player enters that specific area and then execute the code that we need. Basically, an area 2D is an area capable of detecting objects that have a collision, like our player, and then emit a signal when that object enters or exits. So, we can use that signal to execute our code. Okay, now you know how to change scenes, but using a different script for each entry would be a lot of work. So, what we can do is share the same script with all entrances and use the area2D name as a reference for our code, renaming each area2D with the name of the map we want to send our player. Now, something you might have noticed is that when we change scenes, our player appears in the middle of the map. So, to make it appear in the correct position, we are going to use the position2D node. But before that, let me explain something important. When we change scenes in Godot using the change scene code, as soon as the new scene is loaded, the previous scene is closed. So, to save any kind of important information, we need to create an autoload scene. Using an autoloaded scene, when the player enters area2D, it will save its own name, and then, when the new scene is loaded, it will use the saved name to send the player to the correct position. Okay, now all you need to do is repeat the same process for all other map entries using an area2D and a position2D. To make the player automatically walk when changing maps, we need to create a new variable in our auto-loaded scene to save which direction the player is coming from, and then we need to create a new state in our player that will make it move by itself. To show the map title, we need to create a canvas layer and a label with an animation. The text will appear as if it was being typed, and then it will go up and disappear from the screen. To create a simple minimap, we will use a PNG format file with the map design. So, we will use color hacks to hide the parts of the map the player hasn't visited yet. And we will use color rect with animations to show which map the player is on. A very simple way to create items that we can collect is to create a scene that has a sprite with the item's image and an area2D that we will use to call the necessary functions. When the player takes the key, it will save its own name in a list of found keys. And later, when we created the doors, the code will search this list for the correct key. And so, we will see the animation of the door being opened or remaining closed. And finally, we are going to use color hacks that will change colors to represent these doors on the minimap.